Hello everyone, my name is Anderson and this is my partner Ella from Group 7 KPA. Now we want to explain about nutritive and mental caloric practicum, the influence of current in analyzing and how to calculate the efficiency of this practicum. Next, analyzing is an electrochemical process in which the operating conditions such as the temperature of the electrolyte and the electrolyte pH and chemical composition as well as the current density involved play a crucial role and influence the final properties, chemistry, and morphology of the resulting anodic oxide film. Next, aluminium delivers a rare mixture of properties that are valuable. It's just one of the lightest metal on earth. It is nearly 3 times lighter than iron, but it is still quite powerful, exceptionally flexible and rust resistant since its surface is clothed in a very thin yet powerful layer of chromium film. It will not magnetize, fantastic electricity conductor, and types alloy with almost the other metal. Next, sulfuric acid used as an oxidizing agent is a strong inorganic acid. The acid used is acid with a low concentration. The use of sulfuric acid in anodizing is not only cheap and easy to find, but also because the coating has a wide range of aesthetic and functional properties. Next, the most influencing factor of anodizing is four of them. Too many adding electrolyte concentration has effect to metal loss of coating weight. The smaller the current, the brighter the oxide layer. As the temperature of the electrolyte increase, the dissolution of the film will also increase. And of course, adding the duration of anodizing is adding the weight of coating. Next. This process is similar to the mechanism of corrosion in metals. A curtain potential of aluminium metals can be oxidized to form ions so that this metal can bind with oxygen and form an oxide layer. This is the reaction during the anodizing and reaction in anode and cathode. Next. Some function of anodizing and metal coloring in real life is of course coating metals from corrosion decoration with color metal and energy source. For that last, energy source has utilized cathode. The reaction of anodizing where hydrogen can be used in fuel cells to generate electricity or power and heat. Next. The equipment used in this practicum are anodizing equipment set, drying oven, digital scales, colorimeter, digital thermometer, 2 inert metals, and hot stirrer. Next. And there are some materials we use. There are PDIM water, sulfuric acid 0.75 molar, natrium hydroxide 2 normal, deep red and blue coloring, phosphoric acid 85%, and aluminium tip for test material. Next. This is general methodology of this whole practicum. The first one, we give mechanics process to the aluminium tube, then we anodize it. Second, we dip in the aluminium to blue and red dye, then sealing it with boiling water for 3 minutes. The last but least, the aluminium test with colorimeter, and then we do calculation of the efficiency of use of electrical energy during the anodizing process. Next.
And then this is the data obtained during the experiment. Next, first is the environmental data. Experimental data, anodizing data, metal staining data, electric current data in anodizing process. Next. And then colorimetry data. First for the blue metal, and then second for the red metal. In this experiment, we are looking for the energy efficiency used during the anodizing process. Next, first, we must looking for the electrical energy used. Second, we are looking for the electrical energy that released into the water. Percent of efficiency can be found by electrical energy during process minus electrical energy released into the water, divided by the electrical energy during process and multiplied by 100%. Next, this is the discussion session. Next, first is the aluminium anodizing process. The first thing to do is baking the initial aluminium metal, then the cleaning or degreasing process to clean the metal from fat or oil that is on the metal. This process is carried out by immersing the metal in a 2 molarity of NaOH solution for 10 minutes. The reaction that occurs is shown. Then a desmelting process is carried out on the metal to remove aluminium oxide that was formed in the previous cleaning process and make the metal surface uniform, so that the anodizing process is more optimal. We do this by heating solution of 85% phosphoric acid diluted into 2 times to a temperature of 50 Celsius and dipping aluminium metal into it while stirring for 10 minutes. The reaction that occurs is as follows. Then the racking process is carried out, namely the arrangement of the workpiece in a special place to facilitate the anodizing process of aluminium metal. Next. After that, the anodizing process was carried out, namely the process of growing pores in the form of tubes or dead ends on the aluminium metal surface using an acid solution and an electric current. In the anodizing process, the cathode used is solid metal in the form of a plate and aluminium metal as the anode. The electrolyte used in the anodizing process is a 0.75 molarity sulfuric acid solution, and the anodizing process is run for 30 minutes for each variation of the electric current. The reaction that occurs as is follows. At the end of the anodizing process, the mass of aluminium metal is weak again. There was a decrease in the mass of aluminium metal after anodizing. Supposedly, the mass of aluminium metal after anodizing increased. The increase in mass of aluminium metal is due to the formation of an aluminium oxide layer on the metal surface. Next. Second is coloring and sealing process. The anodized metal is put into the dye solution for 5 minutes so that the color can be optimally absorbed in the pores that form on the metal surface. Aluminium metal, which is subject to a current of 2 ampere meter, is dipped in a blue solution, while metal, which is subject to a current of 4 ampere meter, is dipped in a red solution. After that, the metal is put into the boiling water for 3 minutes alternately or a sealing process. The sealing process is carried out to seal the aluminium oxide layer as well as the sealed dye so that it does not fade when the metal is in contact with certain solvents. The reaction that occurs as is follows. Then, measure the metal with a colorimeter. Colorimeter is sensitive to light being measured and how much color is absorbed by an object or a substance. Next. The third or the final stage is to determine the efficiency of the use of electrical energy during the anodizing process. The trick is to measure the temperature of the electrolyte solution before and after anodizing aluminium metal for each variation of electric current used. The electrical energy generated from the power supply may not be 100% used to carry out the chemical reaction. So, that there is electrical energy supplied to change its 2 forms into the energy, namely heat energy. The difference in the temperature of the electrolyte solution before and after anodizing process indicates that the heat is released. The factors that influence this experiment include the concentration of the electrolyte solution used, the electric current and voltage, the length of the anodizing process, and the type of metal of use. Next. The last one is the conclusion of the experiment. First, anodizing is the process of forming an oxide layer on metal by reacting aluminium with oxygen from an electrolyte solution as a medium to form an oxide layer. Second, the higher current used in the anodizing process, the hardness of the metal surface tends to increase. 3, or the last one, is with an electric current of 2 ampere, the energy efficiency used is 25.998%. With an electrical current of 4 ampere, the energy efficiency used is 49.008%. Next. That was the presentation of our group. Thank you.